Now today I am going to start with the another part of this lesson, that is of peacock thrones and elephants. The children, those who are in the class, I couldn't take the class today because of some reason, so I am putting it on the video. Textile art, astronomy, mapping and record keeping flourished during the Mughal rule. Textile means what? Factories preparing cloth. Art means kala. You know, different types of art is taught to you in SUPW. Art and craft. Astronomy means all about the stars, planets, about the heavenly body. Mapping and record keeping flourished during the Mughal rules. Mapping means to map, to count the area, to count the place, to count the distance of the place. Keeping record of all the things flourished during the Mughal rule. But pigeons enjoyed a special place. During this time, the pigeons enjoyed a special place. We shall see how it is. Almost every Mughal roof had a kabutar khana. Now see, if you go to Bombay, to Dadar, you will see there a big kabutar khana. Kabutar khana means where all the pigeons are kept. All totally. It is, I have seen it, you also can see at Bombay, at Dadar, there is a kabutar khana. So, every Mughal roof had a kabutar khana. Means every Mughal roof means every Mughal house, palace, wherever the Mughal people lived, on the top of the house, they had a kabutar khana, where they were fed and cared for. Where they were fed. What do you mean by fed? Giving food. We feed the animals. We feed the birds, we feed the small children. So these birds, the pigeons were kept and they were cared for, they were looked after and they were fed. Pigeons carried letters of all kinds, love letters included. Now what happened? This pigeon carried letters from one place to another, which included love letters. Love letters means prem patra. Some king, some emperor, some Mughal emperor might be writing some love letter to the queen. So this love letter, now sweet letter, nice letters were written and they were attached with a thread to the leg of a pigeon. And this pigeon used to go and give this letter to the place where they are sent. Flying pigeons and of course kites or the patang was an allied Mughal pastime, and many emperors had special pigeon house erected. Can you imagine young Akbar flying colorful kites on the royal roof? Now see, flying pigeons, of course kites, pigeons which are flying, and kites, or you call it kites means you call it patang, was an elite Mughal pastime. It was a very interesting pastime for the Mughals. They used to like flying kites. They used to like flying pigeons. They used to keep pigeons on their terrace, on the roof of the house. And pastime for them was flying kites. Many emperors had special pigeon house erected. Many emperors, many kings has erected a special pigeon house. Like we have pet dogs, we have cat, we have goat, some have cows. So this time, this Mughal emperor had pigeons house erected. They made a special house for the pigeons. Can you imagine the young Akbar flying colorful kites on the royal roof? Can you just imagine now? That time, Akbar Basha, Akbar, King Akbar, used to fly kites on his roof, means on his terrace. And you know, some children fly kites on the ground. Some people fly kites from their building on the terrace. Same way, King Akbar was used to fly kites from his terrace, from his roof. The Mughals prized the elephant over every other animal for its strength and courage. The Mughal prized the elephant for every other animal for his strength and courage. Now what was there? They had elephants. They had other animals also. They might be having some play with them. They might be having some games with them. They might be like, you know, bull fight, cock fight. Then, you know, there are some functions in the villages. Then they run with the bullock carts. Like that, functions were there. And these elephants were brought. And they would see the strength between the elephant and the other animals. They were prized. They were given prizes. Elephants were used to trample prisoner to death. See, what were the elephants specially used? Prisoners, kaidi, if they want to kill the prisoners. Now you know, they hang them, phasi chadate, they burn them, they give the electric shock. But that time, the elephants were used to trample prisoner to death. Trample prisoner to death means they might have making the person to sleep down, the prisoner. And tell the elephant to stamp, trample, trample, trample means to stamp, usko pair se dabochna. And when you know, human being like me and you, if an elephant keeps his leg on our body, we may die on the spot. So same way, these elephants were used to kill the prisoners. Mughal emperors rode beautifully decorated elephants only. And Mughal emperors, they were not sitting on the elephant which you see in the circus. They used to sit on the elephants which were very much nicely decorated. With all shamia, with all the things the elephant is decorated which is looking beautiful. The kings, the emperor used to rode on that, means they used to go for a ride on that. The Mughals were also famous for scents, itars, soap, and of course different kinds of Mughal foods, biryanis, kebabs, naans, shermals, shahi turka, just to name a few. There were special books to tell which perfumes to use where and when. Mehndi or henna occupied a special place both with the emperors and their many queens. Noor Jahan was Jahangir's 19th wife and the most loved, just like Shah Jahan, who had the exquisite Taj Mahal built for his beloved wife Mumtaz Mahal, who bore him more than dozen children. See, the Mughal were also famous for scents. What is scent? Ittar. Usse khushbu aati hai, you put on your body. Scent we say, scent. S-E-C-N-T. Attar. Ittar we say. Attar, ittar, whatever you can pronounce it. Ittar. So, and of course, different kinds of Mughlai foods. They were interested in perfumes. All types of perfumes, even you and I use the perfumes to have a little bit good smell. Sometimes it is odd, so we go somewhere, there are odd smells, the smell is not proper, the area is not good, it smells bad, so people use perfume. So these Mughals were also famous for their scents, soaps, and of course different kinds of Mughlai foods. What were the Mughlai foods? Biryanis. You know what is biryani. Kebab, you know. Naan, you know. Shermals, you know. Shahi Turka, just a name few, and other some things. They enjoyed these all foods. There were special books to tell which perfumes to use where and when. They had some written books where they could, it was written in that book, what time and which time and where this perfume should be used. Mehndi or Hina occupied a special place both with the emperors or with their queens. Mehndi and Hina. Mehndi, you know, you put on your hand during wedding, engagement, birthday party or some function. We also do now. We are copying what the Mughals have done. And especially, you know, Muslim people, they know to remove very nice Mehndi. Not only Muslim but others also, but especially the Mughal peoples. We have learned from them. So we, these Muslim people know how to remove. During engagement, during marriage, during birthday party or some other function, they remove Mehndi on their hands. Then Hina, which we use for our hair. Our hair becomes grey, white. We use Hina powder. So that was very famous with the emperor and the queens. Noor Jahan was Jahangir's 19th wife. Noor Jahan, you know, you have heard about Noor Jahan, was 19th wife of Shahjahan. Noor Jahan was Jahangir's 19th wife. Noor Jahan was Jahangir's 19th wife. He had 18th wife before, she was the 19th wife. And the most loved, and she was the most loved, the 19th wife he loved most. Just like Shahjahan, who had exquisite Taj Mahal built for his beloved wife. Like Shahjahan built a Taj Mahal for his, in remembrance, whose remembrance Taj Mahal has been built? In the remembrance of Shahjahan's wife, Taj Mahal was built, his beloved wife. Mumtaz Mahal, who bore him more than a dozen children. And Mumtaz Mahal was built in the remembrance of Noor Jahan, and Mumtaz Mahal, who bore him more than a dozen. And Mumtaz Mahal had over how many children? 19 children. More than 10 to 12 children. Mughal emperors were weighed twice a year on their birthdays according to the solar and lunar calendar. Now Mughal, what was the system? Twice in a year, the Mughal emperor, they were weighed, unka vajan kiya jata tha. According to the solar and lunar calendar, you know, these calendars are there. In that it is written all the months in Hindi, it's written in Marathi, in Urdu. So twice in a year, according to the lunar and the solar eclipse calendar, they were weighed, unka vajan kiya jata tha. A painting shows Shahjahan sitting with his legs crossed on a weighing scale, with his body weight balance against gold, silver and other valuable things on his 42nd birthday in 1638. Now see, a painting is there, you can see here, that Shahjahan is sitting with legs crossed. Legs crossed means putting his legs one on the other on a weighing scale, vajan kate par. He's sitting on that weighing scale with his body weight balanced against gold. There was a vajan kata, one side he sitting, other side what was put? Gold, silver and other valuable things. When did they do this? On the 42nd birthday in 1638. They had lot of wealth, these emperors, these Mughals had lot of wealth. So that is why that there it was their custom that they veiled emperor twice in a year according to the lunar and solar and lunar calendar. According to the dates of the calendar, they veiled their body with gold, silver and other valuable things. They had lot of wealth. They dressed in the best of clothes. Now see, they also dressed best of clothes like silk, lace, organza, muslin and pure cotton. They dressed best clothes like silk, you know silk, lace you know, organza also you know, that type of all chunky clothes, muslin, very fine cloth like silk and pure cotton. They wore pearls, you know pearls, rubies, diamonds and fancy gold thread, embroidered shoes studded with jewels. Now they wore pearls, hire jawaharat, in their neck, rubies, that is also one type of diamond type, and pearls only, that is also, and diamonds, hire, and fancy gold, and fancy means very decorative. They prepared with all these things, prepared with what? Pearls, rubies and diamond, made it fancy. Gold thread embroidered shoes, and their shoes, now see, your shoes, my shoes, we are having lace, we are having cloth shoes, we are having leather shoes, but they had a shoes embroidered with gold thread. Embroidered means in their shoes the gold thread was mended, the gold thread was put. You have seen the emperor's shoes. Studded with jewels, and they were also studded, means usme aur kya lagaye the, hire jawaharat bhi lagaye hue the. How grand they looked, kitne sundar lagte the, how grand, very beautiful, very nice. Everyone, even more grand were their palaces with the garden and fountains. Their shoes, their dress, their behavior, their appearance looked more beautiful than what they had in the garden and the fountains. The gold crown that once belonged to Bahadur Shah II, the gold crown, crown malum hai, mukut, sar mein jo hum rakhte hai, raja log rakhte hai, the gold crown that once belonged to Bahadur Shah II was inlaid with diamonds, emeralds and rubies, was sold to Queen Victoria in 1861. Now the gold throne belonged to Bahadur Shah II was inlaid with diamonds. It was laid with what? Diamonds, emeralds, other type of pearls and rubies, which are in different, this all pearls, this all diamonds, rubies, they are of different colors, was sold to Queen Victoria. You know Queen Victoria, she was a queen of England. It was sold to her in 1861. Today it is in possession of Queen Elizabeth II of Britain, as is the Kohinoor diamond, and that is known as Kohinoor diamond. Now today, first it was sold to Queen Victoria in 1861, later on today it is in the possession of Queen Elizabeth II of Britain, the Queen of Britain, Elizabeth, Queen Elizabeth II of Britain, as this is Kohinoor diamond, and it is that crown is known as Kohinoor diamond. Delhi, the seat of Mughal Empire at that time, was an idyllic green city with many trees and far less people than today, with delightfully empty roads sprinkled with camels, elephants and horse carriages. Now Delhi, the seat of Mughal Empire at that time, was an idyllic, idyllic means very empty, very idle. That was green city. There was no rush as today. If you go to Delhi today, you will see there is no place to walk. Transportation, other carriages, all the other vehicles. But that time it was idyllic, with green city, with many trees and as far less people than today. And there was very less people that time. Most was greenery, all clean place with delightfully empty roads. The roads were very delightful and empty, sprinkled with camel. Sprinkled means everywhere the camels were spread. Elephants were there and horses, carriages. And what was there? No cars and buses, everything was there, but horse carriages were, ghoda gadi was there. Chandni Chowk, facing the Red Fort, was a beautiful stretch of road. Chandni Chowk, it is there in Delhi today also, facing towards the Red Fort, was a beautiful stretched road, a big, very big road, with carriages taking the beautiful princesses and queens dressed in the most gorgeous clothes and jewelry. Now see, Chandni Chowk facing the Red Fort was a beautiful stretch of road. It was a very big road with carriages taking a beautiful princess. Ghoda gadi, taking beautiful princesses means king's wife, emperor's wife, and queens. Rajkanya, princess means Rajkanya, and queens, Rani, dressed in the most gorgeous clothes and jewelry. They used to wear very beautiful. Looking at them, you just have to admire what type of clothes they are wearing. And jewelry means sab jevra. Jevra, all the chains, all the rings, and whatever the ladies has to wear. To the many bazaars. And they used to take them to the market. Meena Bazaar was famous special market inside the palace grounds for the ladies. And in every palace, there was a Meena Bazaar where only ladies could go. It was meant only for the ladies. All the things for the ladies were kept there. Who could remove their veils? Here. Now you see, in that time, Mughal time, the ladies had to put veil, means parda. They have to put a whatever they are wearing, that veil means dupatta, they used to have to put on their face as they are going on the carriages, as they are going out, as they are going coming out of the house. But when they went into this Meena Bazaar, they were allowed to remove this veil, to shop for cloths, jewelry, and painting, and often attended by the emperors themselves. And what happened? They could remove their veils. Why they could remove their veils? Because they could shop for clothes. If they put the veils, if they put the parda, they will not be able to see. They will not be able to see. So they were allowed here to open the veil, remove the parda, so that they could shop, they could purchase clothes, jewelry. You know what is jewelry? All the ornaments and painting, and often attended by the emperors themselves. And sometimes what happened? Many times with the princess, with the queen, the emperors also went there to the market. Such was the life of a Mughal era at that time. Would you have liked to be born then? So you tell me now, children, that was the era, that was the period of Mughal time. It was very luxurious. It was very happiest. It was very wealthy. I hope that you would have liked to born that time. Thank you. Have a nice day. And today I couldn't put this video on the in the class for the children. So I am putting for everyone this video today. And the question answers which are remain, I shall put as per I get a time. Thank you.